Amazing when you get an important subject like this, you get back in on Friday afternoon. We appreciate y'all coming. I'm Gary Black, Commissioner of Agriculture, the State of Georgia. I want to welcome all of y'all. We've got a distinguished panel up here that will have an opportunity for some great exchanges today to talk about this most important issue in agriculture, and that is the 2012 Farm Bill. I appreciate our members of friends and media being here today. Sometimes we are busy in Atlanta trying to improve the literacy of the general media when it comes to the things of agriculture, and our outreach efforts are beginning to work a little bit. But sure it's good to come to Tifton, where your news media outlets actually understand what heartbeat this part of our state, and certainly the heartbeat the entirety of the state, that is agriculture, and certainly our future before us. Some of the questions that we've talked about over the past few minutes is just, you know, what kind of farm bill, where to go, why is it so important? And certainly today, I think our distinguished senator and these other folks who have their hand on the pulse of American agriculture are going to share with us that certainly having a safety net for the future is a very, very important issue for all of us. And it's probably going to come in a little different form this time. Our traditional programs will change. It's one of those important discussions we're going to be in front of us today with regards to the future crop insurance. Widely, other things when it comes to those commodity programs, I would argue that when you look at the world market prices and our current set of policies, I would argue that our last farm bill worked quite well because our costs are not there. We're competitive in the world market. And certainly some of those normal things that we budget for, we did not have those outlays during the life of this bill. But we all know that our country faces a very serious budget challenge before us. We have accumulated an incredible amount of debt. We have some serious issues facing the economy, the livelihoods, quite frankly, every family in America. And agriculture will have to be part of that team that helps bite the bullet, so to speak, as we move forward. But certainly, I think all of you would agree that what we don't want to do is agriculture, even though our budget would not be able to, we surely, truly don't want the perception of American agriculture, trying to balance the nation's budget woes on the backs of American agriculture when we're pulling the weight all the time. And so to that end, it's going to be incumbent upon all of us to work with our leaders, work with our members of Congress to make sure that we have a fair piece of farm legislation that meets our needs when it comes to a safety net and certainly meets the budget objectives that we're with those disciplines that we're going to have to be engaged with. Another thing that some of our friends in the media asked just a few minutes ago, and I think it's important to point out, it's important for everyone in this room to communicate to you the fact, and I think the last numbers I saw, Senator, and the current farm bill and the costs associated with it, while I think the farm bill before, about 73% of it were actually food assistance program. Since we've not had the outlays, that number shot above 80% now. 80% of the farm bill is actually not, it has something to do with food, but it's not those things that are directly related to agriculture. Many times we have our commodity programs under severe attack, and that's what farm can get labeled with the farm bill, and the general public loses sight of the importance of this omnibus type of legislation there in their life. It's going to be